FiLiA means daughter. We are the daughters of the women who came before us, and we fight so that our daughters may be free. We are a women-led volunteer organization. Our vision is a world free from patriarchy, where all women and girls are liberated. We seek to contribute to the women's liberation movement by building sisterhood and solidarity among women, locally, nationally, and globally. By amplifying the voices of women, particularly those less often heard or purposefully silenced, and by defending women's human rights.
Hello. Dear visitors, thank you for coming to the second part of the FiLiA webinar, Sex Trade Survivors Demanding the Global Change. I am Luba Fine from FiLiA. 13 exited survivors from 12 different countries are participating in this webinar. Our next speaker now is Huschke Mau from Germany. Oh, we have yet another cat lover here. So what was the criterion to be included in this webinar, I wonder? Okay, Huschke Mau entered the world of prostitution as a traumatized 17-year-old girl. Her first pimp was a policeman. She was trapped in prostitution for many years and survived rape, drug and alcohol abuse, and suicide attempts. After being finally able to exit prostitution, she attended university and completed her master's degree. These days, she is working on her PhD. And this is amazing because this world needs more systematic knowledge created by survivors. This is what we are doing today. Huschke Mau is also an activist for the Nordic Model. She has founded Netzwerk Ella, an organization for abolitionist sex trade survivors in Germany. Huschke is a brave and fresh abolitionist voice, one of the first who revealed to the world the atrocities of the legalized sex industry in Germany. I was privileged to hear some of her speeches in live, and they were so powerful. I really envy you that you are going to listen to her today. Thank you so much for coming here to share your wisdom and your knowledge, Huschke.
Oh. Thank you so much for inviting me. I have to apologize for several blackouts and stuff. I got vaccinated and I still have a little fever. So if I begin to stutter or something, please be kind. I would like to talk about the consequences of legalization as we see it in Germany. I guess you know that in Germany, we have one of the most liberal prostitution laws in the world. So we can see where that goes and where that ends. At first, I would like to reveal some numbers. So in Germany, it's said that we have 400,000 women in prostitution. But that's not for sure because we don't even know the number of women in prostitution in Germany. It's from 40,000 to 500,000, we don't know. What we do know is that in Germany, 1 million Johns visit a brothel every day. 1 million Johns every day. And that since full legalization law in 2002, over 100 women in prostitution were murdered. So let's talk about the consequences. First, I would like to say why I think prostitution is violence. It doesn't matter in which conditions prostitution takes place, there's something wrong with it. Because the yes, the woman in prostitution says is a yes to the money and not to the sex, sex is still unwanted. And unwanted sex is sexual assault or rape always. And money doesn't change that. And it's a strange male behavior to sleep with a woman without being able to say whether the woman actually wants that or not. The punter or the John cannot tell afterwards if the sex was forced or not. He goes away and he can't tell whether he just raped or not. And that is clearly sexual problematic behavior. So what are the consequences of acceptance and legalization as we see it in Germany? We had a law in 2002 that fully legalized prostitution. And what we see, what happens is at first, the consequences for the woman in prostitution, there are almost no exit programs anymore. It's treated like a job. It's a job like any other. And women don't get help anymore. It's private or church organizations who do the help. But the help does not come from the state. So we see legalization makes prostitution a trap for women. 9 out of 10 women want out and they cannot. They receive no help. The second thing we see is that legalizing prostitution deproblematizes sex buying and covers up the sexual abuse that's happening. It's treated as a job. The brothel owners here are called landlords. Pimps are called businessmen, and the Johns are normal clients. That doesn't take away the hurt and the trauma that prostituted women experience, and it does not help against stigma. Prostituted women here are still very much stigmatized. It's the John who don't need to be ashamed anymore, since it's said they are just buying a normal service. Legalization does not help against the war stigma. It just helps Johns to not face the consequences of what they do. Johns became very much enabled because of the legalization law. They feel entitled. And if they are not content with the performance or the service, they will emphasize their demand. I had so many clients who ignored when I was crying or when I was in pain, and they demanded I stop looking disgusted or stop crying because paid is paid. Since it's legal what they do, they feel they have a right to sex because they paid for it. And if they don't like the performance, they sometimes even take women to court. We had a young girl here. She was raped at 17 and then she was in prostitution. And she had a John who was unable to orgasm and he took her to court over it and she had to pay 500 euros. So this is what happens when you legalize prostitution. Also, it brutalizes the clients. The sex practices become more and more violent, sadistic, because it's just a service and it's okay to do it. They don't feel they do this to a human being anymore. And yeah, that leads to an escalation of violence. We have so many beatings and rapes in prostitution. The women don't even go to the police. And we have many, many murders. It's over 100 murders since 2002. So in 20 years, 100 murders. The next thing is that legalization definitely creates more Johns. Laws have a normative effect, and if it's okay to do it, more people will do it. In Germany, many men do it. As I told you, every day, 1 million men go to a brothel in Germany. Every day, 1 million men. And when you have more clients, more money gets into the sex industry system. That means more brothel owners, open brothels, and that means more women are needed. And this is where the human traffickers join the game. There will never be enough women who do this voluntarily. The biggest part will always be forced. And the society that accepts and legalizes prostitution accepts human trafficking and forced prostitution. You can't have one thing without the other. So legalization leads to more clients, leads to more brothels, leads to more human trafficking and forced prostitution, because pimps and traffickers all also want to make money and satisfy the demand of the Johns for young women. The police now has no way to enter brothels anymore, since they are normal businesses. They need an initial suspicion that a woman is forced or a minor. But how can you get a suspicion when you're not allowed to check the brothel rooms and the people in the brothel in the first place? So in legal brothels in Germany, there are many forced women and trafficked women, and this goes completely under the radar. It's the legal brothels and the legal street prostitution where this happens. So legal prostitution is not the good prostitution on the one side, and there's and it's not the bad illegal prostitution on the other side. It's legal prostitution where human trafficking and forced prostitution takes place too. And this is the spiral down as we see it in Germany. You have more clients, that means more brothels, that means more trafficked women, more men without compassion, more Johns, more brothels, and so on. It's like a suction where more and more women and girls become drawn into the sex industry. Germany has become a sex tourism destination, and we are called a brothel of Europe, and the title is very well earned. Of course, in Germany, human trafficking and forced prostitution is forbidden, but that doesn't change a thing, because the pimps and the traffickers, they use the legal infrastructure to run their businesses. It's legal brothels, it's legal street prostitution where this happens, and it's mostly unchecked. So what happens when you have more Johns in a society? More clients mean more men with problematic sexual behavior. So when you have a society where you have very many Johns, like we have, you have many men who show sexual problematic behavior. And we see that this affects non-prostituted women too, because of course, when a man learned that under certain circumstances, it's okay to have sex with a woman who doesn't really want to and doesn't really consent to this, this is a lesson that doesn't stay behind closed brothel doors. It's a behavior that affects all women. All women in the society have to deal with Johns, if they know that or not. And there are studies which prove there are more rapes in society where prostitution is legalized. A society that accepts prostitution is a society that accepts violence against women. And that fact clearly does not make a society more woman friendly, and it does not help when it comes to gender equality. So there's a complete blunting when it comes to prostitution in Germany. There are pimps in talk shows laughing about the fact that the police think to let prostituted women work for 16 hours a day is slavery. Pimps sit in German talk shows and laugh about it in public. And there are soccer clubs who distribute brothel coupons to their male audience. There are school books with tasks like build a perfect brothel, a brothel for everyone, an inclusive brothel. Yeah, we see these effects, and they are clearly a problem. And there's a last point I want to talk about, and that is that to accept prostitution and sex buying deepens every single way of discrimination a society has. I mean sexism, classism, racism, anti-Semitism, and so on. Because it allows the discrimination to become fetishized and acted out and connected with sexual degradation through prostitution. For example, ethnicity is fetishized in prostitution. And to allow prostitution makes the country more racist because the sex buyers who, for example, buy Asian women like an object won't see other non-prostituted Asian women like humans after that anymore. And of course, it's colonialism when we as a country have, 19% of all women in German prostitution come from really poor European states like Romania, Bulgaria, and so on. And they are so young and so desperate and so poor, and they are here just to suck the dicks of our German men. And this is clearly, we have a class of women who are nothing but sexual slaves for German men. And this is so racist, and so it's like Germany is still a colonialist state or something. And the society doesn't even realize that. And this is truly, truly shocking. We even have events like Frankfurter Bahnhofsviertelnacht. This is, in Frankfurt, in the red light district, there's a party once a year, and you can go through the brothels like, you're going through a zoo or something. And everybody can visit the brothels that day, and they go through the brothels and see the half naked, very young Bulgarian and Romanian women who don't even know what happens, who don't speak no German and so on, and they are being looked at like this is just so racist and degrading and inhuman, and I have no words for this, but yeah, prostitution does make a society more racist. And there are so many brothels who work like that, brothels with racial apartheid, where you go to the first floor and there are the Romanian women, you go to the second floor, there are African women, you go to the third floor, there are Asian women, and so on. And it reinforces racism because those women, they are reduced to racial stereotypes. Asians are submissive, African women are promiscuous and wild, and so on. This is what the Germans buy. They buy a racist stereotype. And when you have many Germans in a society, of course you have more racism in a society. So men buy women reduced to racial stereotypes, and combined with the sexual degradation that prostitution is, this amplifies racism and allows racism to be acted out. Another truly shocking example is that we have a very well-known luxus escort in Germany. And she offers some role play for German Johns, where she plays the Jewish girl. And I have no idea what kind of role plays she has with her German Johns. I don't want to imagine, but this is, wouldn't it be in prostitution, everybody would look at this and would say, wow, this is completely wrong, and this is anti-Semitism, and this is racist and all. But since it's in prostitution, it seems to be okay. And John, we see also that Johns use very racist and sexist slurs against women, and they try to offer refugee women from Syria and so on money for sex too. So they go and offer money to them. And they are happy that they are here. I heard some Johns even say it's good that it's war in Syria. That means there come a young, desperate woman, and we can have them for sex. So this is welcome to John's world. So what I want to say is to accept men to buy sex and therefore to buy one is making society more violent in every way you can think of. There's more violence against women and girls in prostitution. There's more human trafficking and more forced prostitution. There are more brutal clients, more murders, more rapes on prostituted and non-prostituted women, more woman hating and more racism. So prostitution affects the society as a whole, and this is why we need to abolish it. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Huschke. You contribute so much knowledge and understanding of the legalized sex industry and its consequences for the society in general. I think that you know, many people learn from you the truth about the legalized sex industry, because there is still the myth, because Germany is a progressive country, it is a Western country, they legalized prostitution, so it must be good. But nobody can insist that legalized sex trade is good after listening to your speech, to your presentation. So thank you so much.